Before you start building your own README file, let's first take a closer look at the various sections that make a README useful. For this example, we're going to be taking a look at Ledbetter, a project that's maintained by GitHub itself. Now, I don't really know what Ledbetter does, but that's not what we're looking at here. We're looking at the language that's being used in this README and the parts that make it up. A README should provide just enough context to get a user up and running with your code. Keep in mind, we are writing this for other humans. We'll start with a title and a description. A sentence or two will work just fine, but be sure to capture the spirit of your project clearly and concisely. This will help frame the reader's experience when going through your documentation. If you're feeling extra fancy, you can include your project's logo if it has one. Next, include any information that is absolutely necessary for understanding your code. This may be dependencies on other software or libraries, installation instructions, common usage, or known bugs. It's worth mentioning once again that there's no formal standard for what a README should look like. Don't feel pressured to make your README any particular length. Some can be extremely short, while others will need to be much longer. It just depends on your project. The important part is that you communicate clearly and concisely any information that is essential for the user, and that you don't make any assumptions about what the end user already knows. It's up to you to decide what is and isn't essential information. A few good questions to ask yourself include, what are the exact steps that need to be taken to get this code base up and running? What should they already have installed or configured? What might they have a hard time understanding right away? Often, developers will include a getting started or installation section to help with any initial setup that may need to happen before using your code. If it's helpful, include example code to better illustrate your end user's proper usage of your code. It's important to be mindful of the assumptions you make about what the user's expected to know. Remember, you're familiar with your code already, so think about it from the perspective of someone who's never seen this before. For instance, if I were making eggs Benedict and my recipe called for a poached egg, I might be alienating new chefs by not explaining what a poached egg is. Ultimately, the amount of detail that you choose to include is up to you, but for particularly difficult concepts, it might be a good idea to include some extra detail.